Good evening, participants. So today I am going to discuss correlation, and after that we will discuss regression. Basically, correlation, it's a measures of association of two variables. So correlation means association. More precisely, it is a measure of the extent to which two variables are related. Therefore, when one variable increases as the other variable increases, or one variable decreases while the other decreases, so its value between -1 to +1, and there may be two types of correlation. One is positive correlation and another negative correlation. So as we know that in a positive correlation, as we increase the one variable, the other variable also increase, and the variables, you can see the two variables in the x-axis, that is one variable, like the one variable and another variable. This is x variable and this one is y variable. When we increase this variable, the value of one variable, then what will happen in the outcome variable? So there may be two possibility. When we increase the value of the x variable, then value of y also increase. It means it's just a correlation. You can see it's a positive correlation. And when we decrease the one variable, outcome variable also decrease. Again, it's a positive correlation. And second condition, that is when we increase the one variable and decrease the value of outcome variable. So it's a negative correlation. Okay. In a negative correlation, there is an inverse relationship between the two variables. So in a positive correlation, the one variable increase, the other variable also increase. Now, what is the value? Because the correlation basically the standard form of covariance. Variance means when we check the dispersiveness of one variable. So it's a variance. It means, so I am taking the one variable. Here the one variable and the variation of the one variable about the mean value, it may above or below the mean value. So it's a variation of one variable. And covariance means, so when we talk about only one variable, so it's a variance, and maximum variance may be 100%. But when we talk about the correlation, so correlation basically we 50-50% we divide in the two variable. Why? The one may be dependent variable and another may be independent variable. So the covariance tell us about the relationship of two variable. When we increase the one variable, so what will happen to the outcome variable? So there is the covariance, it's an unstandard form, because it is very difficult if the two variables correlation 200, covariance 200, and the another is 300. So naturally, we can say the covariance, the dispersiveness of the two variable it is more. But when we standardized this covariance, then it becomes the correlation, and the value of this correlation between -1 to +. -1 means when we increase the one variable, the other variable decrease. It's the negative or inverse relationship. So if value of the two variables x and y -0.91, it's not perfectly, but it's a strong negative correlation or strong negative association of two variables. Okay. And when the value of the two variable correlation value, if its value -0.2, 2, 3. It is a negative correlation, but not strong. It's a low correlation. So correlation, basically, we can divide into the three. One is the high correlation, medium correlation, and the strength of the correlation. We can measure the value through the value. If the value minus 1, minus 0.91, 0.81, so it's a high negative correlation. And its value, if 0.6 to 0.3, it's a medium correlation. And if its value minus 0.3 to 0, it's a low correlation or low association between the two variables. It's not perfectly. Same as in a positive correlation, if value near to 1 plus 1 means 0.9 or 0.8, it's a high correlation or a strong association between the two variables. And if its value plus 0.3 to 0.6, it's a medium association between the two variables. And if its value less than 0.3, it means a small correlation. Okay. Now, correlation can be understood through the type of data, what type of data we are measuring. Okay, so data may be metric data and the other non-metric data. So in a, the bivariate correlation, basically, there are two types of correlation. One is bivariate, means two variable. I am measuring only two variable. Bivariate correlation is a correlation between two variables, and partial correlation looks at the relationship between two variables while controlling the effect of one or more variables. What does it mean, the partial and the bivariate correlation? So in a bivariate correlation, say, for example, I am taking the multiple regression equation y equal to beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 and many other independent variable, and this is error term or disturbance term. Okay. Now the correlation between the x1 and y, it may be the positive, negative. This beta 1 tells us whether the relationship between the two dependent and independent variable positive or negative, and its value also tell us whether it is the high correlation, medium or low correlation. When we simply take the correlation between the x1 and y, so it is a bivariate correlation. Although other variables also influencing this y dependent variable. And partial correlation, when we specifically see the impact of this and control all the other variables, so it's a partial relationship. Bivariate means we are measuring the relationship or association between x1 and y, and we are not controlling the other variable. We are taking all the independent variable in our study, and so it may be the bivariate correlation value may be different from the partial correlation, because in a partial correlation we are not adding other variables. Okay, so this is about the partial and the other correlation, partial and bivariate correlation. So you can go through in a detail. I have shared the book, ND Field book. It's a very beautiful book, ND Field, Discovering of Statistics Through Spaces. So I have taken all the examples in a ND Field book. So you can, in this book, you can understand how to perform the particular statistical tool and technique, how to analyze this technique, and how to interpret the particular output, and how to report these things. So I have shared in a group this book. So the next is the after this, the there are two bivariate means two relationship. Now the bivariate the example of bivariate coefficient गुड इवनिंग सुल्तान सिंह जी, गुड इवनिंग. ओके, the bivariate regression, the example of bivariate correlation coefficients are, one is Pearson product product moment correlation, and other is Spearman's row correlation. Okay, so it is again the types of database, type of data we are taking. Data means there are two types of data. One is metric data and another is non-metric data. Non-metric means the interval or the categorical and ordinal data, and metric means interval or ratio scale data. Okay, so the technique of the Pearson product moment, the example of bivariate correlation, one is Pearson a product moment correlation and another is Spearman correlation. Now what does it mean, the Spearman and the Spearman correlation and Pearson moment correlation? The in a bivariate correlation, we should see the condition when should we use the Pearson correlation coefficient, when the both the variable dependent and independent variable and the data are normally distributed, then we find the Pearson correlation coefficient. It's a parametric. Both variables should be continuous. Continuous means my data should be either in an interval scale, my question should be either interval scale or ratio scale. If my question interval or ratio scale, both the questions dependent and as well as independent variable, and the both the variables normally distributed, then we use Pearson correlation coefficient, find the association between the two variables. Okay, so the again it is depend on the types of data. So it is very important, the data when we are using any statistical tool and technique, we should check the which type of question we have prepared for our research paper or the thesis. Okay, so the second is the Pearson correlation, Spearman correlation coefficient. When should we use Spearman correlation coefficient? It's a non parametric data. It means it non-parametric means it should either it is a nominal or ordinal data. When both the variables in an ordinal form, ranking form, the data dependent and independent variable, and data not normally distributed, then we find Spearman correlation coefficient. So here in the first case, it's a Pearson correlation coefficient, and for non-metric data, means ordinal data, we use Spearman correlation coefficient. So we should be very careful if my data in an ordinal form. So we should not use the Pearson correlation coefficient. Pearson correlation coefficient can be used only for parametric data, means metric data. Data should be continuous. Okay. So the data should not be normally distributed. And the third type of correlation you have here, this Kendall tau, that is the, it's a non-parametric test, Kendall tau. This means that if you rank all of the scores, so we rank only ordinal data. Okay, when we rank all the scores and many score have the same rank, means tie, rank tie. Yesterday I discussed the sum score may tie. Okay, then Kendall tau should be used instead of Spearman coefficient. So when should we use the Kendall tau again? So because it's a very minor difference, when should we use Kendall tau, when should we use Spearman correlation, although in the both the test either Spearman correlation coefficient and the Kendall tau. Both are non-parametric, and we use ordinal data, the metric ordinal data for dependent and independent variable. So when should we use the Kendall tau and Spearman correlation? The Kendall tau when we obtain some tie score, same score, same rank, then we use the Kendall tau. Okay, so it's a very small difference in a Spearman and Kendall's tau use of institute of coefficient. It is appropriate for a small data set, and again it is appropriate for a small data set with a large number of tied score. When we are getting large number of tied score, then we should use Kendall tie. Means we should not apply any statistical tool and technique without knowing the assumptions of each test. So first of all, if you are using the Spearman correlation coefficient, then we should think what are the assumptions of the Spearman correlation coefficient, and in which condition we should use the Kendall tau method. Okay. Now the next is the Kendall tau bivariate. Both variables should be the condition of the variable. We want to measure the association between the two variables, but both should be ordinal data. So we should keep in mind, if my data, both the variable, ordinal form, like in the Likert scale. So instead of finding the product moment correlation coefficient, we should use either the Spearman correlation coefficient or Kendall tau method. Okay. Now biserial and the biserial and point biserial correlation. These correlation coefficients are used when one variable, these coefficient, correlation coefficient are used when one of the two variable is dichotomous. Dichotomous means nominal scale, categorical data. Okay. So there may be the other condition, the dependent variable continuous, but this the independent variable categorical. Then how will we find the association between the two variables? So it's a when we have one dependent variable in a continuous form, means interval or ratio scale data, and the independent variable in a the categorical form, then we should use biserial and biserial correlation. The point biserial correlation. So I request you please go through the ND field book to understand the difference between the point biserial correlation and biserial correlation, so you can understand detail if you go through this book. It's a very good book. Okay. Now the point biserial correlation coefficient is used when one variable is discrete. One variable is discrete means the one variable categorical variable. Then apply, just the example of the categorical or discrete variable. Discrete dichotomy means dead or alive, male or female, rural or urban. Then apply apply Pearson correlation to find the point biserial correlation. Then second, the biserial correlation coefficient is used when one variable is continuous. Okay. Example, passing or failing, continuous dichotomy. It's a, okay, the passing or failing an exam. It's a continuous dichotomy, not exactly, because it cannot be calculated direct in SPSS. So we cannot find the biserial correlation coefficient in a SPSS. So then next is the partial correlation is the measure of association between two variables. I already told about the partial correlation. Partial correlation is the measure of association between two variables while controlling or adjusting the effect of one or the other variable. What does it mean? Through multiple regression analysis, we can understand it, like y, that is dependent variable, and beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 plus beta 3 x3 and so on, and the disturbance term. So the when we want to measure the association between two variables means one dependent variable and another independent variable, and the control the effect of one or more additional variables, then it's a partial correlation. When we find the partial correlation between the x2 and y2, then we find we control the effect of the others. Okay. Yes, a Likert scale we can use to use biserial correlation coefficient to find out the correlation. So I discussed about this. So if you want to know more, so you can go through this book, ND Field Book. I have discussed this. No? So you can listen the video. So the other is five participants are joining. Okay. Now the partial correlation. Then after that, the partial correlation can be used in many cases that assess for relationship, like whether or not the sale of value of a particular commodity related to expenditure on advertising, when the effect the partial correlation can be used many cases that cases for relationship, like whether or not the sale of particular commodity is related to expenditure on advertising when the effect of price is controlled. It means there are two variables to find the correlation, partial correlation. The one variable, that is the sales, it is sales, and another variable, that is advertising expenses. This is advertising expenses, and the effect, another variable, the B2X2, it's a price. Price is independent variable. If we increase the price, naturally sales will decrease. If we decrease the price, sales will increase. So it's an inverse relationship between the two. So if we want to know the impact of only the advertising expenses, and we are not taking the price in our study, so we can find the partial correlation between the two variables. Okay. So if we want to find the impact of price, and we control the advertising expenses, then we can find the partial correlation of price with the other. Okay. Now I am sharing the SPSS sheet to discuss all the tests. So I am taking the case study first. The bivariate Pearson product moment correlation. So I am explaining each. Now the Pearson correlation coefficient. So in a Pearson, I think you can see it. So in a Pearson correlation coefficient, it's an example, it's a case study. So in a Pearson correlation coefficient, what is the condition? The variable should be the continuous variable. So there are the three variables. The variable, first variable, that is revision time. Okay, revision time. And exam performance, second variable. And tension, exam tension, third variable, and fourth variable, that is categorical variable, nominal scale question, gender. Okay, so in this case study, we want to find the correlation between the two, the exam performance, like the exam performance, and is it any relation between the exam performance and the revision time? So through correlation we can understand. So there are two variable, the Y, that is exam performance, okay, and another variable revision time. Okay, so as we know, the as we devote more time to our study, the exam performance also increase. So there is a positive correlation between the two. Whether it is strong, medium or low, so we can find through the correlation. Okay, so as we know, there is a theory suggest also the revision time and exam performance positively related or positively associated to with each other. Okay, the second condition, the exam performance and exam tension. So here, the as your exam tension increase, exam tension, your performance affect, exam performance affect. You are in a highly tension, the high value of tension, then low value of the performance. As your tension reduce, means less tension, then your performance good. This is the performance, the exam performance and exam tension, and exam less tension, you are high performance. Yes, and your high tension, low. So there is you can see it's a negative or inverse relationship between the two. Now we can find whether the tension, the graph or the association of the two, whether it is positive or negative between the two variables, is it same for male or female? Okay, so we can find it also, like there may be the positive correlation for male, so then we can understand there may be positive correlation and value it 0.78. okay, it's a revision time and exam performance, it's a correlation of male. Is it necessary that this correlation would be same for female? Although it would be the correlation would be positive, but we cannot say the value of the same for both. The there may be possibility that the female correlation may be high. Okay, so we can find the difference of the male and female also. Now I am performing the Spearman correlation coefficient to understand the association between the two variables. So here I am performing the, just look at here, apply, analyze, correlate, correlation, and bivariate. I'm taking all the three variables simultaneously and transferring in a variables. And then after that, the options. So nothing to do here. I don't need, by default Pearson. So we do not need to tick any other option, because why am I ticking the Pearson correlation coefficient? Because the data is metric form. That is why. Kendall tau means if data is the ordinal data and tau score and sample size less. Spearman means data ordinal and normally distributed, but sample size large. Okay, so here by default Pearson correlation, and then two tailed, and here flag coefficient, flag significant correlation. Because correlation may be significant or not significant, it is depend on the p value. So if p value less than 0.05, then we can say it's a significantly positive or negative correlation between the two variables. So p value and when we see the star, then star suggests us it's a the positive correlation. Okay, positive or negatively correlation, but it is significant. Now I am sharing you the output of this Pearson correlation coefficient. Now in this output, we can see there is a two types of correlation. One is the one correlation, the revision time, and the other is exam performance. So I am making the graph, the X and Y. Revision time, it's a I'm taking on a X axis revision time, and exam performance the positive. So what is the value? The value is plus 0.36, and it is significant. It means if you are in, but it is not highly positively correlated, because it's a medium effect. We can say the exam performance medium, the association with the exam performance and revision time, there is a medium relationship or medium association, because p value 0.36. Now second is, so your graph may be look like it's not complete straight line, it may be some dispersedness type. We will get this type of graph, so I will show it through graph also. Second condition, we can see here the exam tension, it's a x-axis exam tension, and the y-axis exam performance. As exam tension is low, then your performance is high. As in exam tension increases, it also decreases. So now it increasing and the exam performance decreasing. So there is a negative correlation between, or negative association between the two variables. But what is the value here? Here the value of minus 0.661, although it is significant, but we can say it's a the medium effect, or because perfectly negative correlation means when we obtain the value is minus 1 exactly. So it's a medium effect, medium correlation. Whether it is significant or not, who will tell us? There are two stars. If we obtain the two star, it means there is a significant impact. And this p value also, this p value also suggests us there is a significant impact, significant association, or significantly related to each other. And the other is the relationship exam tension and exam performance, third relationship, because we have transferred three variables. So exam tension and the exam tension and exam, one is exam tension and exam performance. Second is exam performance and revision time. So, and third is revision time and exam performance. Revision time, the one is revision time, and the other is exam performance. It's a positive correlation. First, second, exam performance and the revision time. So exam performance, as we increase the revision time, there is a positive correlation, and exam tension and revision time, there is a negative correlation. So it's a y-axis means revision time, it's a revision time, and exam tension is on x-axis. So as you are more time, you are more tense, you give less time to your the revision time, because you are always thinking about the you are in a fear, so you do not give much time to revision time. So there is a negative relationship. If you are less tension, you give more time to revision. So there is a strong, the minus point, it's a minus 0.45, it's a negative relationship between. Okay, so this is about the it's a concept of Pearson correlation coefficient. And in a Pearson correlation coefficient, we can see the association between the two variables. It may be positive and as well as negative. Okay. Now here we can see the the exam performance negatively related. For example, the value of minus 0.45. So how much it vary? It's a correlation. When we square the correlation value, it becomes the variance. Okay. So the what will be the square value of minus 0.45? Its value will be 0.2025. It means 20%. So we can interpret it through the percentage form also. Okay, how much this particular indicator influencing the other variable. Now I was talking about, so we can see it's a table for only both. This table provides us the results of both male and female. Now if we want to find the correlation for male and female, then we need to split our file and then we will find the correlation coefficient for male candidate and female candidate both. Okay, then how to do it? So I am sharing you the slide. This slide is this Pearson correlation coefficient. Okay, so now you can see this slide, Pearson correlation coefficient. So it's a, I want to check correlation gender wise, male and female. So I need to split this file. So how will I split this file? You just see here the data and you can see here split file. Okay. Then data split file. And then after that, compare groups and gender. I'm transferring here gender. So compare groups and gender and transferring here group based on, because my purpose to get two outputs, one for male and another for female, and then okay. Now my file has been splitted. Now you can see the file. So the file, you can see the file, whether this file is split or not. How will we find whether it is splitted or not? Through here. So right lower corner, you can see here, right lower corner. So we can see the file has been splitted on the basis of gender. Okay. Because here written split by gender. So we have splitted our file to check the association for male and female separately. Okay, no problem. So it's a below the, it's a right corner. So now I am performing the correlation again, analyze correlation and bivariate. Okay, and bivariate. So the gender I have splitted this variable and then okay. And after okay, so we will get the output. So I am sharing the correlation for male and female also. Okay. Now you can see here, there are the two groups. One is for female and another for male. So in this case, the Pearson correlation revision time and exam performance. It's a, the, what is the value? The, it means the female, especially the female, when they devote more time on a revision and their exam performance better, because R value 0.405, this is female, and for male, male, it is also positive related, but here the relationship, its value R equal to 0.329. It means female perform better when they revise more and their performance is good. Okay, because the R value, the Pearson correlation coefficient more than the male participants. Okay. Now, same other is the female exam tension. So, the revision time and exam. The second is the revision time and exam tension. So, what is the value? It's a negative relationship. Exam, exam tension and the revision time. As your exam tension increase, you give the less time to revise because it's a negative. When you are less tension, you give more time to revisions. When you more tension, girls, female, more tension, they give less time to revision. So here are value minus 0.773. Where while we can compare it to boys also, so but boys are less affected, although they are affecting the exam tension. The value of R minus 0.458. So I told you earlier, it is not necessary the correlation between the two variable for male and female will be same. So if we want to compare, then we can interpret that the female, when they are in more tension, they give less time to revise. And it's a hypothetical study. And for male, it's a less value in comparison to female. So this is about the correlation for continuous variables. Okay. Now I'm checking the other, the second case study, Spearman correlation coefficient. When should we use the Spearman correlation coefficient? So I am sharing you other data set, the data set for Spearman. Now you can see this data set. Okay. It's a data set. Now there are two variable and a Spearman correlation coefficient. I told you when one variable is the in a continuous and other is ordinal, then we use Spearman correlation coefficient. Okay. So if my data one, the correlation coefficient, between the two variable, we can find. So here in this case study, first of all, we should understand the case study. The case study is, it's a data of about 10 last 10 years data. It's a data of 10 years data. And the one event conducted by organization, it is related to creativity. Okay. The person who obtained the high marks get the rank one. Okay. The person whose score is high obtained the rank one, and second less score, the rank two, and the third score, the rank three, and fourth rank, the 42 score, and the fifth means this. So what is the association? So what type of association we will get? It's an inverse. Inverse means because numbers, if we are giving rank one for maximum number, as number decreasing, rank increasing. As number increasing, rank increasing. So it's an inverse relationship. So we will get the negative correlation between the two variables. So it's a score of the 1 year. This is another year. So total 50 observations we have. And through this, we want to find the association, creativity and rank. So I told you it's an inverse relationship. Inverse means negative relationship. Because through data, you can see the one is increasing, creative score increasing, rank decreasing does not mean the performance is decreasing. Because coding for rank is one. Okay, so here we will find the negative relationship. Now, how to perform Spearman correlation coefficient in SPSS. So analyze, then correlation, then bivariate transfer both the variable, one continuous and another the categorical variable. Okay, and then I will tick here Spearman instead of Pearson. I am not ticking it Pearson. So tick Spearman. Why? Because my one variable ordinal and another is continuous. Okay. Now the flag significant coefficient and then okay. And after okay, we will get the output. So I am sharing the output. This is your output. Okay. So here we can find the negative relationship. I already told you the when the creativity score is increasing, the rank the value of rank is decreasing means number. I am talking about numbers. So here the creativity Spearman's raw value, it's a Spearman raw RHO. What is the value? -0.804. So this is, so we can find the non-parametric. It's a non-parametric correlation because the one variable is the ordinal data. That is why it's a non-parametric correlation. And if both the value in a ordinal scale, again we will use this non-parametric correlation means Spearman raw. So Spearman raw basically useful for when our data is non-parametric. Okay. Now this is about the and now I'm checking the third case study to explain Kendall's tau study. Yes, 5% लेवल पर हम चेक कर सकते हैं, वो ऑलरेडी दिया हुआ है इसमें, इसमें हम लोग चेंज भी कर सकते हैं, मैं अभी देखता हूं, so I can see it. Now third is, चलिए मैं, I'm showing you the 5% or 1% bivariate percent exclude, इसमें दिया नहीं है परसेंट वाला. Percent flag coefficient. Okay. लेकिन कई जगह होता है correlation का. We can find the 5% and 1% significant level also. Now the third case study, it is related to Kendall's tau case study. This case study, Kendall's tau. Third candle star. Okay, now in this, it is also same case study I am taking to explain, but the results would be same. Okay, result would be same in this case study, same case study which I have covered in a Spearman raw correlation. Same case study I am taking with the tie score. Okay. So how to perform Kendall tau? Same data I am performing. Analyze, then correlation, and bivariate. Its value will be low, I think. The Kendall tau I am using, and both the variable I am transferring because I do not have the data set of tie score. So I am applying Kendall tau method this case study, and then okay, and after okay. So its value, I told you, its value will be less. Now you can see the output and can compare. So in the when we use the Spearman correlation coefficient, the value of the R means Spearman raw value, that is -0.84, and when we use the other method, that is the rank in the competition, its rank is -0.763 because there are some tie score. So we can find the correlation coefficient, Spearman correlation coefficient, and as well as Kendall tau coefficient. Now this is after that biserial and point biserial correlation. So I am taking my fourth case study to explain the biserial and point biserial correlation coefficient. The point biserial correlation coefficient. Okay. Now in this case study, it's a time and gender and record means here I am taking the one for cat. The coding 0 means female cat and 1 means male cat. Okay, so male and female gender, and in the third column I change the coding. Okay, 0 for male and 1 for female. In this data set, so there are 3 variables. One is time spent by male cat, and so not visible. Okay, I'm sharing again, no problem. Okay, point by, okay, I think you can see it now. So these are the 60 observations, 3 variables. One is the time spent by the there are cat, male and female. Okay, so the it's a coding one for male and female for 0, and the another we have record again reverse the coding, now 0 for male and 1 for female. So basically there are 2 variable, one gender and another time. Gender means categorical variable, and time means time is spent by the cat. It is the continuous variable. Okay. Now I am performing the point biserial correlation. How to perform it? Analyze, then correlation, bivariate, correlation, bivariate, and transfer both the variable time away from home by cats and gender of the cat. Okay, and then the Pearson. I am checking Pearson, and then okay. And after okay, this is the result. So in this result, we can find in this output, we can find there is a positive correlation between the gender of cat. It means the time away from home, the male cat go out more time and devote more time outside the house in comparison to female cats. So it's a, if we want to, it's a, it is known as the correlation of point biserial correlation. This type of correlation known as point biserial correlation. If we reverse it, okay, if we have reversed the coding, now we have taken code 1 for. So I am sharing the slide here, the coding in the first gender, the 1 for male and the 0 for female. If we take the 0 for male and 1 for female, what will be the result? Analyze, then correlate, bivariate. Now I am taking another variable, cat gender record, and then okay, after okay, negative correlation. What does it mean? This is a negative correlation. Here there is a negative correlation. It means female cats the time the female cats spent less time outside the home. Okay, so it's a negative relationship. And when we code one for male cats and zero for female, we find that the time away from home, the male cats give the more time. So it's a point by serial. Point means there are two category, male, female. If we want to find like this, so we should use point by serial correlation. And the by serial correlation coefficient cannot be calculated directly in SPSS. The another point was the by serial correlation. So can we calculate the by serial correlation coefficient? No. The bi-serial correlation coefficient cannot be calculated directly in SPSS. So through formula, we can find the bi-serial correlation coefficient. You just go through the book ND field. So you can understand the concept of point bi-serial and bi-serial correlation coefficient. Now I'm taking the other example, the partial correlation. What does it mean, the partial correlation? How to find the partial coefficient of two variables? In a partial coefficient, I'm sharing the previous data set, the revision time, exam performance, tension, and gender. Okay. Now, partial means transfer. Here I am transferring the variables. So, analyze. Partial means I am taking relationship with one dependent variable, one independent variable, and controlling the effect of the second variable. Because in this case study, three variable, revision time, the second is exam performance, and third tension, exam tension. Then how to find the partial correlation? Partial correlation, I told you earlier, the bivariate correlation value means product moment correlation value, and the partial correlation value will be different. So we can check it through this analysis. Analyze, correlate, and bivariate. So I'm transferring all the three continuous variable in a variable box, and the transfer exam performance and exam tension, exam performance and exam this. Sorry, galat maine likh diya. Again, I am repeating the procedure. Analyze correlation partial, not bivariate, partial. Analyze correlation, correlate partial, and then the two variable I am taking, exam performance and exam tension, exam performance and exam performance. So I want to know the relationship between exam tension and exam performance. So we know that there is a negative relationship. As exam tension increase, exam performance decrease. And I'm controlling the effect of this. Okay. So now we will find the partial correlation. So partial correlation, the partial correlation means there are the one variable y, beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2. So exam performance depend on the exam revision, the exam tension, and another variable revision time. So I want to find the relationship between exam performance and exam tension. So we know that there is a negative relationship, but I am controlling the effect of revision time. So I have transferred revision time in a controlling form. So we can see the analysis, and then okay, and click zero order correlation. Here I am. So zero order correlation. Zero order correlation means bivariate correlation. Zero order correlation, and continue. And then continue after that, okay. And after okay, we will get the result. So I'm showing you, result, output, देखिए मैं जो WhatsApp ग्रुप है आज कल मैं डिलीट कर दूंगा उसको, और जिनको सर्टिफिकेट अगर चाहिए किसी, हालांकि कोई सर्टिफिकेट की बहुत ज्यादा वैल्यू नहीं होती है हमारे पढ़ाने, इसकी कोई वैल्यू नहीं है, यूजीसी या ICSSR वाले की वैल्यू होती है, बट इफ समवन नीड्स दी सर्टिफिकेट सो आई विल शेयर गूगल फॉर्म, ओके, गूगल फॉर्म में मैं कुछ इंफॉर्मेशन पूछूंगा, द फुल नेम, बिकॉज आई नीड टू राइट योर फुल नेम इन अ सर्टिफिकेट, देन डेजिग्नेशन वेदर यू आर रिसर्च स्कॉलर और द टीचर, एंड थर्ड इज द इंस्टीट्यूट नेम, ओके, तो तीन चीजें आप भर दीजिएगा, और ईमेल ऑल्सो, ईमेल इसलिए कि मैं ईमेल पर भी या व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप दोनों पे मैं आपको सर्टिफिकेट बना के एक दो दिन में भेज दूंगा, है ना, थोड़ा टाइम लगेगा। नाउ नाउ कैन यू सी दिस, ओके, दिस आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द पार्शियल कोरिलेशन, ओके, द पार्शियल कोरिलेशन and the zero order correlation, there are two different things. Partial, when we control the variables, we are controlling the variables in a revision time, okay, when we control the revision time, in this case you can see it's a control the revision time. So what is the exam, the relationship exam performance and exam tension, because I have taken two variables in this box when I transfer exam performance and revision, sorry, exam performance, exam performance, and controlled kiya tha, controlled was the revision time, okay, revision time, when we control it, the partial correlation means the relationship between exam performance, exam performance, and the exam tension, exam tension. So there is a negative correlation, and what is the value? R is minus 0.297. The R equal to minus 297. But when we add revision time also, so what was the revision? So in this exam tension correlation, the influence of revision time also influencing this to increase the exam tension correlation. But separately, when we take individually, how much this particular exam tension, the relationship between exam tension and exam performance, it is lower than here. So in this case, it's a zero order means when we take all the variables in a correlation, and R is minus 0.45. But if we want to find the specifically the impact or association of this exam tension on exam performance, it is lower than this previous. Okay, the 0.297. This is the partial correlation. So we can find the individual, like the y equal to beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2. When we control the effect of revision time, this is associated negatively, minus 0.297. But when we take this variable also in a to find the correlation of x1 and y, then its value increase, because it is also influencing this variable. That is why the value different from the zero order correlation with the partial correlation coefficient. So this is about the correlation coefficient. Now I am taking the regression analysis, multiple regression analysis or regression analysis. Next is the regression so I am sharing this slide to another slide, regression analysis. multiple regression analysis. For multiple regression analysis, bivariate regression analysis means when we take only one variables. So I am showing you the slides. Reading the slides of multiple regression analysis. Is it visible? Can you see the can you see this slide? Please inform me. Can you see the multiple regression analysis slide? Thank you. Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Now, multiple regression analysis, it's a multivariate technique. In a multiple regression analysis, basically it is a statistical tool, statistical technique that can be used to analyze the relationship between a single dependent variable and several independent variables. Now, in case of the simple regression analysis, we take only two variables, one dependent variable and another independent variable. While in case of multiple regression analysis, the condition is we use one dependent variable and another interdependent variable. Okay. What is the purpose? How to decomposition of the total variation in a regression? So basically, it's in x-axis independent variable and y-axis the dependent variable, and it's a regression line. You can see here the yi means it's a the observed. The yi means value of individual observation, and y cap means estimated predicted value, and y bar means the average value of all observations. So y means individual actual value, and this value yi cap, it is observed value, actual, and y means value of individual observation, and y cap means estimated or predicted value. What does it mean? It's a individual value, observed and predicted. Predicted means we obtain the predicted value through the formula, and observed value means our actual value. So if my observed value and actual value same, it means there is no variation, there is no error. Okay. On the basis of advertising expenses, I want to predict the sale of after 1 month. If my this sale and my formula also give the same sale, means observed value and predicted value is the same, it means there is no error. My model is good. But if my observed sales 10 lakh rupees and predicted value telling me the sale would be 8 lakh, so there is an error of 2 lakhs. So residual means it's an error. And explained variance means it's a, if my one independent variable, 80% is explained correctly, so there is 20% the error term or the residual. So if my sale after 1 month, 10 lakh rupees, and my model is saying the sale is 99 lakhs, so error is 1 lakh rupees. So if observed value and predicted value near, then model is fit. But if observed value away from the predicted value, means 10 lakh observed value and 5 lakh the predicted value, so it's a very difference, very gap between the two variable, it is not desirable for our study. So here there are two terms. We can total variations, we can divide into two parts, residual variation and explained, or we can say explained and unexplained part. So in the case of the multiple regression analysis, So there are many variables we take in our study. So the variable like independent variable, the my many independent variable, one the y that is dependent variable, and beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta x2 plus beta x3 beta 3 x3 and so on. This is error. If all the three independent variable vary, this dependent variable, the about 70% variation due to these three variable. It says sales dependent variable, advertising expenses the another variable, discount independent variable, availability of the product another variable. If you provide availability of the product more, then naturally sale will be increased. So these three variables are influencing 70%. The variation is 70% due to these three independent variables. Or we can say it's a explained part. Explained part. And the other is unexplained part. It means other variable also can influence this is. We did not take the other variable in our study. If we take or add more variable, the variance value will be high. So there are two parts. One is explained and unexplained. So unexplained means this residual, and explained means this. So desirable is it should be greater than 50%. Okay. If my model explaining high, it means sometimes what happen, our regression model, some people R square value is very like 12% and sometimes 30%. So model is not fit. Ideally, theoretically, R square value should be 60%. It means the explained our model predicting well, 60%. Okay. So we should keep in mind when we are entering the independent variable, as we increase the number of independent variable, the value of R square increase. Okay. So it is about the, we can divide total variation into two parts. One is residual and another is explained. So there are many terms we can use. We can error term, we can use instead of residual term. Okay. So the total variation explained part plus residual variance, sum of square y equal to sum of square regression and sum of square residual. So how do we find this value? Through this formula, we can find the value of here. So if you want to calculate manually, you can do it. So here my objective to explain the concept of multiple regression analysis. Okay. Now how to perform the multiple regression analysis. So there are six stages of multiple regression analysis. One is objectives of multiple regression analysis. What is the objective of my research? Is it predicting something or not? If I want to predict, then I should use the multiple regression analysis. If I want to know the impact of several independent variable on dependent variable, then I should use multiple regression analysis. So first of all, we should define the objective of the multiple regression analysis. Why are you theek hai, ye certificate ki baat hum kar lenge iske baad bhi hai na, mujhe aap WhatsApp pe likh lijiye. I will give you the ye kya naam hai, de dunga, aur mera mobile number aapke paas hai, aap mujhe baad mein bhi kar sakte hain. Now second is research design of multiple regression analysis. What should be the sample size to conduct the multiple regression analysis, and how to select our questions, dependent and independent variables, and what should be the nature of the variable? Is nature of variable metric data or non-metric? So we will discuss all the issues in a research design of multiple regression analysis. Then the assumptions in multiple regression analysis. So before applying the multiple regression analysis, we should check the assumptions of multiple regression analysis. Broadly, there are four assumptions of the multiple regression analysis. If we fulfill all the assumptions, then we should use the multiple regression analysis, and then estimating the regression model overall fit, and the interpreting the variate and validation of the result. Now, first is objective of multiple regression analysis. So there are two things. One is prediction and explanation. Objectives of multiple regression analysis, basically we use the objective of multiple regression analysis, basically prediction. Prediction means on the basis of several independent variable, we predict the dependent variable, like sales depend on advertising expenses, availability of the product, price of the product, quality of the product, discount of the product. There are many variable influence the sales of the product. Okay. Now, the predicted, then second is explanation. Explanation means there are three things in an explanation. We are taking the many independent variable in our study, like the one that is dependent variable, y that is the dependent variable, and another beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 plus beta 3 x3 and so on. So here the explanation means we consider three things. One is magnitude. So if we want to find the relationship between x1 and y, what is the magnitude of this regression coefficient? So it's a value, standardized value will be between minus 1 to plus 1. But unstandardized value may be 2.5, 80.3, anything. But standardized value of this regression coefficient between the minus 1 to plus 1. And the sign, also the second thing is sign. If the sign of the two variable x1 and y, that is positive, it means there is a positive relationship. It means when we increase the one variable, we also find the outcome variable also increase. Okay. And the third is statistical significance. Whatever independent variable we are taking in our study, whether x1, x2, x3, whether all are significantly contributing to dependent variable or not, who will decide? So we will decide the p value. Will decide whether all the independent variables significantly contributing or not. Sometimes what happen, we take many variables in our study, in many independent variable like beta 1 x1, beta 2 x2 plus beta 3 x3 plus beta 4 x4 plus beta 5 x5 and so on, and this is error term. These are the explained term. So when we check individually the hypothesis, whether this particular independent variable significantly contributing or not, so p value tell us. If p value less than 0.05, it means there is a significant impact of this independent variable on dependent variable. If we find the p value less than 0.05, and we reject null hypothesis and accept alternate hypothesis, it means there is a significantly this x2 x3 variable significantly contributing to this, same as x2. But if I'm taking five variable, it is not necessary all the variables significantly contributing to the our dependent variable. There may be possibility that the other variable x4 and x5, they are contributing to the dependent variable, but not significantly. So we will not take these two independent variable in our actual model. So actual model will be the beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 plus beta 3 x3 and so on. This is my actual model. to predict the this dependent variable. Okay. P value means if P value, I told you in SPSS, when you are either you are using the if you are using one sample t test, independent t test, pair test, correlation, regression, or factor not factor analysis. The other is the ANOVA, ANCOVA. When you want to find the whether the particular independent variable significantly influencing the dependent variable or not, so this p value tell us. If in a SPSS, the p value tell us, it's a probability value, means if p value less than 0.05, it means this particular individual variable significantly contributing to this. Okay, now after that, the research design. What should be the research design for the multiple regression analysis? So what should be the sample size? Sample size means 5:1. If you are taking 10 questions in your study, one dependent variable and x1 plus x2 plus x9 independent variable. So at least we should sample size should be 10 times of the 10 variables. So total variables, 10 variables. So what should be the sample size? So we should take at least 50 sample size. We should ask, we should distribute our questionnaire to 50 respondents. Okay. Now preferably 15:1. If sample size is, if 10 variables, but it is preferable, we should take the sample size, 150. This is good. It is preferable. Okay. So sometimes I told you sample size again depend on the type of particular statistical tool and technique. It is not necessary that we should take the sample size the rigid. So there is a flexibility also. The particular statistical tool and technique also tell us what should be the minimum sample size. Okay. Now the what type of variable we should take here. The variables, all the variables, either dependent or independent, all the variables should be metric form. It's a condition. It means when we want to perform the multiple regression analysis, so all the questions should be metric form. Means our question should be either interval or ratio scale question. We should not take ordinal and the nominal scale question. We cannot apply, and we should not apply this technique. So again, so how to prepare our question for the multiple regression analysis? This is the these are the question we should prepare our question like this. So it's a case study. I will discuss. I will take this case study to explain the multiple regression analysis. So. There are four questions: sales in thousands, advertising budget or expenses in thousand, discount on products. We are giving the percentage 20%, 25%, 30%, 40%, and number of shops. All are continuous variable because it starts from zero. Sales we use in rupee term. Rupee cannot be negative. Advertising expenses we use. Rupee term, advertising expenses, discount cannot be negative, always positive. Number of shops cannot be -2 shops, always positive. So all variables are ratio scale questions, means continuous question. So it is desirable for our study. So then what are the assumptions of multiple regression analysis? So basically there are four main assumptions of multiple regression analysis. One is linearity of the phenomena measured, means when we are taking three independent variable and one dependent variable, the partial correlation between means the association of dependent variable with x1 when controlling the other two variable, it should be linear relationship. Linear means there should not be any the curve in a relationship. When I am checking the two variable, one variable A. Okay, so here I am checking the linearity of the phenomena means. So here the variable in this equation, I have three independent variable, beta 1 x1, beta 2 x2, and beta 3 x3 plus added. So the when the controlling the effect of x2 and x3, there should be the linear relationship between x1 and y. It may be positive linear or negative. If my diagram look like this, so it's a positive correlation. It should not be like funnel shape. It should not be look like this. If the distribution of data or association between the two variable look like this, so it is not desirable. It's not linear. So it's not if my shape of the curve like this, it is non-linear because it is increasing, but after certain point it starts to decrease. It's not desirable for study. It may be positive or negative, doesn't matter, but there should be linear relationship, either positive or like this negative relationship. Okay, then it's a first condition. If our data not normal, not linear, then we should not use the multiple regression analysis. After that, the second assumption, now you can see the relationship between the sales and advertising expenses. So there is a positive correlation. In both the cases, you can see the positive correlation in a two variable. So the positive correlation here, you can see here, there is a linear relationship. Linear, it's a linear relationship. Okay, there is no curve in a data. It is not like, if it is like this, then it's a negative correlation. Non-linear relationship. The second assumption, constant variance of the error term. What is the error term? So I told you the error term initially, when decomposition of variance, the error term means actual minus observed, the predicted. So this is my mean value. So this is the individual observation actual, and this is the predicted value, and this is mean value. Okay, so the difference between the two, it is known as the error term, and this one, it is explained part, or we can use another term, unexplained part, or residual, another name residual we can say. It's a regression. So the constant, the variation of the error term, not the variable, the constant variation of the error term, the variation of the error term should be constant. So this picture, the constant variation of the error term. So error term, the picture should be look like this. If my picture is this, then I can say there is a constant error term. Now it's a zero line, so I am drawing the line parallel to the x-axis. Okay, so the variation more or less 2, and here the variation minus 2. It means the variation of the data above and below should be constant. Okay, if the range is this, then the data is constant variance. The data is homogeneous. Homoscedasticity in a data, not heteroscedasticity. It's a homoscedasticity in a data. So only vary one or two observation away from this range. So this is the heteroscedasticity and homoscedasticity of the data. Third is independence of the error term. Independence of the error term means the one day actual sale and predicted sale difference, the difference between the actual, or I can say the observed and predicted, okay, it should be unrelated to the other day. If I'm taking 30 days observations, predicting and observe. So the difference of each day error term should be unrelated. So through Durbin-Watson test, we check it. Generally, we check this assumption in a time series data or panel data, but in cross-sectional data, we do not require it. Normality of the error term. Normality means the bell-shaped, the data, the histogram should be bell-shaped of the error term. If it is in a like this, if it my data in a bell shape, then I can say the data is normally distributed. You can see the PP plot, probability plot, all the observations more or less on the principal diagonal. If it is away from this, then data not normal. Then multiple R square, the multiple R value should be above theoretically greater than 0.77, and R square theoretically should be 60%. But it is not necessary that every time we get the this. Rarely we get the 60%. But in many regression models, we do not get this one. So this is about the case of multiple regression analysis. Now I am taking the how to perform the multiple regression analysis in a SPSS. So I am showing you the data set and taking the case study of a multiple regression analysis. Multiple regression, simple case study, this, yes. We should actually, if your assumptions fail, then we should take another independent variable. If we are taking independent and dependent variable theoretically supported, and we are selecting the, because sometimes when we select the dependent and independent variable wrongly, then we do not get the assumptions. So we should check our study also. We should go through the review of literature, and cautiously we should select the dependent and independent variable. Now you can see this case study. Is it visible? There are four variables. One, sales, that is a dependent variable. Advertising expenses, independent variable. And discount, discount, and another is shop. So there are four variable. One, dependent variable. Sales depend on advertising expenses. As we increase advertising expenses, people get more aware about the product and services and they buy the product. So there is a positive correlation. Discount also, we give a high discount, sale also increase. Number of shops, if there is one shop in a city, this sale will be limited. If we, for example, the one outlet of a, so when we open many outlet in a city, naturally sale will increase. So this is the case study. Now I am performing the multiple regression analysis. Analyze. Then regression. After that, linear. Linear. And then sales dependent variable, and all the three variables are independent variable. Advertising budget, discount, number of shops. So I'm transferring here and enter stepwise. Stepwise means first of all, the model one means one dependent and one independent variable. Second model means one dependent variable and two independent variable. And third means one dependent and three independent variables. Okay. Now, statistics, and then after that R square change, descriptive statistics, partial, part and partial correlation, Durbin Watson. Here we can take confidence interval 90% or 99 whatsoever. Okay, and then continue. After continue, plots Z predicted transferring in a x-axis, Z residual on a y-axis. I need histogram, normal probability plot, produce all partial plots, and then continue. And after continue, say, oh, I don't need anything. No, and then okay. Now I am sharing my output. This is my output. I think you can see it. In the first descriptive statistics, you can see the sales in 1000, the mean value 19,246. We do not need. Now we can find the correlation. So as I told you, all the independent variables positively correlated with dependent variable. So you can see the sales and advertising. Sales and advertising 0.60 positive correlation. Discount 0.565. Number of shops 0.290. Only three variables are positively correlated and significant. Here significant, you can see all the values are the 0.0. It is significant difference. Now the model summary. Model summary, there are three models. Model one, what does it mean, the model one? Model one means when we take one independent variable with the independent variable. One independent variable with the dependent variable, like y and beta 0 plus beta 1 x1. It's a model number one. Model one. Because here predicted advertising expenses. So x1 is advertising expenses. So when we take only independent variable, although my multiple regression analysis, beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 plus beta 3 x3, and so only three independent variables. In a model one means when we take only the single independent variable, then this variable R means this value, multiple R value 0.60, and when we square it, this alone only 36.7% vary to the dependent variable. In a model two, it means the 100 minus 36.7, the other variables which we did not take in our study can explain more. Okay. In the model two, why when we take two variable beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2. What is x2? X2 is discount. There are two. advertising expenses and discount. So how much it vary? 59 point. So 59.7%. And when we take all the three variable, then it give us the picture 62.1%. 61 point the picture. So R is, as we increase, we should keep in mind, as we increase independent variable, R square value increase, R square value increase, R square value increase. And adjusted R square value also increase, also increase, also increase. But when we add more independent variable in our study, R square value always increase, but after a certain point, adjusted R square value will not increase. So it gives us the clear hint that we should not take these variables. Okay. So what is and adjusted R square also tell us about the cross validation purpose. If its value, it's a 36.7%, and the adjusted value 36 point, if both the value more or less same, then we can say our model is fit. Now, the what is the R square change? R square change means this is the R square, and the change value is 58.85. What does it mean? This value 56.851. When we take only one variable in this one model, the F value is 56 point this, and this is significant, and this is the significant. When we take the two variable, the R square increase, adjusted R square increase, and the R square change, what is the value? 0.230. How did we calculate it? We calculate, it's a difference of this 0.588 minus 0.361. So we can obtain the value of the R square change. This is when we take the difference of the two, we will get the value of this. So the R adjusted R square value, adjusted R square value, basically R adjusted R square value give us the picture. For example, this is my model beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 and beta 10 x2 x10 and so on. So if only three independent variable significantly contributing to this and seven independent variables not significantly contributing it, always when we add the independent variable number 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 up to 10, R square value will increase, but after a certain limit, it will, the adjusted R square will start to decrease. It means it is giving hint us that we should not include and but the what include these variable. If we are taking these variable are not significantly contributed to this. And the how do we can actually R square can be calculated through sum of square, sum of square regression means explained part, and sum of square residual part, sum of square residual, sorry, sum of square total. Then we get the value of R square, and adjusted R square, we can get the value through this formula, 1 minus R square and the N minus 1, N means sample size, and upon N minus K minus 1. This is the formula of adjusted R square. So always adjusted R square value less than the R square. N means sample size, K means the number of independent variable. So we can find the adjusted R square by using this formula. This is about the R square and adjusted R square. Now we are taking all the three. Now the change in the change in the F change. So here F is, so the 56, and it is significant. It is significant. And the Durbin-Watson is 1.697. Ideally, it should be, 2, but it is near to 1, this. So we can say there is no problem of the constant error term. There is, then the ANOVA table tell us the all the independent variable are significantly contributing to the dependent variable. We've got p-value 0, p-value 0, p-value 0. And now the next is the next is next table. This is important table. In this table, we can see this when we take only one variable, then this one is our final model, because we are taking three questions. So what is the my model? Y equal to, y means sales, equal to -7306.423 plus 8.917 into advertising. I'm writing here X1 plus 326.932 into discount. So I'm taking X2 plus 1003.005 into a number of shops. This is my final model. We report only this unstandardized. We should keep in mind. We do not present our result standardized form. So this is my original model. This is my model. So we report this model. So this is about the multiple regression analysis. Thank you very much, all the participants. You patiently listen my lecture 5 days. Thank you very much. Standardized and unstandardized means it's just like a correlation and covariance. The unstandardized value may be infinite, so it is very difficult to interpretation purpose. So we standardize the value, and it is the value between minus 1 to plus 1. Thank you very much. If you have any query, you can ask me. So I'm just unmute to all. अभी देखिए, अभी last time अभी हमने जो किया था वो full वाला लिया था, जिसमें सभी हमने वो किया था multivariate technique भी. तो last time suggestion आया कि आप जो है इसको two time में divide कर लीजिए, basic और the advanced में. तो अगली बार फिर कभी मौका मिलेगा हम लोग जो है exploratory factor analysis, multiple regression, discriminant analysis, cluster analysis, logistic regression and structural equation modeling, उसको फिर अब कभी हम आगे करेंगे, है ना. तो आज के लिए हम इतना ही रख रहे हैं. थैंक यू वेरी मच. और कोई क्वेरी हो तो मेरा मोबाइल नंबर आपके पास है ही, व्हाट्सएप नंबर है. यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम टू आस्क मी क्वेश्चन. इसके बाद भी हम ले लेंगे क्वेश्चंस. ठीक है सर.
थैंक यू सर.
थैंक यू
सर.
Thank you so much, sir. This session was amazing.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
Okay.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much.